You stay here. I'm going to telephone.
Right.
I'm mighty glad to see you again, Charlie.
Captain Flynn, most happy to meet old friend. You work fast as usual. I'm in town only an hour, and yet already you have telephoned me.
Boy, the minute I got your telegram, I started watching all trains.
You contact mysterious Mr. Roush?
Sure, picked him up the minute he got off the train. And Hodge, that's one of my men over there. He and I have trailed him for 7 hours.
Roush, no, you follow him?
He couldn't help it. I figured you were about to make an important arrest, so we've kept close to him. He's on that tug over there now.
I did not want to arrest him yet.
You didn't?
Roush's agent, in pay of someone trying to steal radar secrets from our government, merely wanted you to locate him so I could observe him myself.
Oh, so you could trail him to the head of the gang who's trying to steal the radar, eh? Oh, gee, I'm awful sorry, Charlie.
Oh, no matter, no matter. Perhaps we arrest him anyhow. Then we put him someplace where you not be sorry anymore.
Oh, thanks.
Roush, use this car?
Oh, no. No, that was parked when we got here.
Still on the boat.
All right, let's go. Roush. He's dead, stabbed within the last 20 minutes.
Here, print. Someone stepped in blood, leave print. Captain, murderer arrive and depart in car on dock, which just leave.
And I didn't even look at the license plate.
I look.
Get me the coroner. Hello, Doc. This is Flynn talking. We just brought in a homicide. Get me a quick report, will you? Thanks. Sit down, Charlie. Come on. Give me the radio room. This is Flynn talking. Check on a stolen car numbered,
9B2X54.
9B2X54. Yeah? Huh.
That car's been reported stolen by Miss Diane Hall, a radio actress of the Cosmo Radio Center.
Cosmo Radio Center. They broadcast by television.
Yeah, their offices are on the 10th floor.
10th floor? Same floor as Hamilton Research Laboratory.
Yeah. And say, doesn't that fella Hamilton experiment in radar?
Radar, radio. Believe we'll soon meet Miss Diane Hall. Tonight.
If he ain't a black market man, my name ain't Birmingham, and I can prove it is.
He's right. That man's business is as dark as...
It ain't exactly that dark.
Can you identify him from a picture?
Yes, sir. As mad as I am with that man, I hate to think of what I think of him. It makes me blush.
Here, look through this.
If it's in here, I'll sure find it. And I hope it's in there, too. Now, let me see. No, no. That's a funny little character, ain't it? No, no. Uncle Nicodemus. Now, I wonder what he's doing. Look at that zoot suit he got on. It's killing him, ain't it?
Yeah.
Big house sure makes some funny suits. There he is. Mm-hmm. No. Let's see. Right along here. There. Mm-hmm. Let's see now. No, that ain't him.
It's right. Why did you turn that page over so quick?
Oh, that page? Oh, that's a desperate character. You don't want to see that. Come on, we're going to look over here. Now, right here. He's right over here.
Well, somewhere. I want to look at it.
All right. If you...
Uh-oh.
Well, what you know about that?
What do you know about that?
Well, you see, it's a little, it's a little error. You see, I had that suit made for a masquerade. I went to a ball, you know, and I win the contest. And you should have seen me dance. I jumped up. Here's the step I did.
You expect us to believe that?
Well, it could be.
Are you two trying to kid us? I'm going to run you both in.
Look, wait a minute. You can't do that to us. I came here looking for Pop.
Yeah, you don't know who he is.
Hey, wait a minute. What's going on here? Who are these two?
He says he's Charlie Chan's son.
But so sorry, you must apologize, Captain. What he say is true. This is number three son, Tommy. And this one is second assistant, Birmingham Brown. Both at times often feeble-minded.
All right, boys.
Now, you two are supposed to take baggage to hotel.
We did, Pop. Then we came looking for you. You know we have to look after you.
You look after me until I'm out of sight.
Oh, Pop, you know we're a big help to you. Your worries are our worries. In fact, no trouble is too big for us.
Some of your trouble too big for me. Come, we must investigate slight case of murder.
Murder? Well, here I come.
Here I go. The end of the line. Now, she can't do that to me. I paid her my alimony this morning. She can't do that to me. Mr. Chan, come get me out, please. I didn't change my mind. Mr. Chan.
Mr. Brett, the manager is coming right out, Mr. Chan.
Thank you.
I'm Mr. Brett, Mr. Chan.
So happy to meet you.
I'm sorry to keep you waiting, but we've just finished a broadcast. Now, why do you wish to see Miss Hall? Is she in trouble?
I wish to speak to Miss Hall regarding her automobile.
Oh, well, right this way, sir.
I mop and mop and mop, so why you walk on the floor till my nerves go yingle yangle?
Well, we haven't learned to walk on the ceiling yet.
I speak serious stuff, and you speak yorks. Who are you? What you want here?
I'm Tommy Chan. This is Birmingham Brown. We're assistant to Charlie Chan, the world-famous detective.
Hold that. Miss Swenson.
You bimini. Sorry, Mr. Brett.
Right this way, Mr. Chan.
They told me to advertise on the air. Well, any program that smells like the one you people just put on needs the air. And you think I'm going to continue paying you... Well, this is radio. I try to put on a program, and the manager himself lets in tourists to gape at us like goldfish.
Mrs. Marsh,
Herbert.
People...
Herbert Sinclair! You were supposed to definitely inform the management that I wanted no sightseers in the studio while my actors were either rehearsing or broadcasting. Quiet! Never mind making excuses.
Mrs. Marsh, these people are not tourists. This gentleman is here because, well, it's something I'm sure won't happen again.
You've said that before. And so have you. Don't talk back to me. Well, what do you want?
Really wish private conversation with Miss Diane Hall.
You wish to see me?
You are Miss Hall?
Yes.
Permit me to introduce myself.
Permit me to depart. Breaking into conferences that I'm paying for. Come, Herbert.
I am Charlie Chan, representative of federal government.
The federal government?
The law?
Oh, well, when the law arrives, Willie Rand departs. Toodaloo.
Miss Hall, tonight you report car stolen.
Oh, that. But it wasn't stolen. It was merely borrowed.
By whom, please?
Well, I don't know. You see, Gloria and I... Oh, excuse me. This is Gloria Bain, Mr. Chan. After rehearsal tonight, Gloria and I went out to the parking lot.
And Diane's car was gone.
So I telephoned police. Then we went to a restaurant, ate, talked with some friends, and came back up here.
And there was Diane's car right back in the parking lot.
Your car missing about 8:30 tonight?
That's right. But how did you know?
And why should the federal government be interested in a stolen car that wasn't completely stolen?
That is all. I'm most fortunate to have met such charming radio ladies. Hope to meet you again. Very soon, perhaps.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Sir, to meet a gentleman who apologizes for bumping you in these days is a rare thing indeed. He is either a coward or a gentleman. I give you credit for the latter.
Mr. Chan, this is Mr. Horace Carlos, the Shakespearean actor, now of motion pictures and radio.
And television, Mr. Brett?
Of course.
Yes, once the foremost Shakespearean actor of my time, but now, char. Now I am known only for the mask behind which I hide when I play the mad monster. On radio, screen, and television. Still, it is a living. And so, good night to you, one and all.
Carlos acts on and off the stage. Did you learn everything that you came to see Miss Hall about?
Yes, thanks for our kind assistance.
Well, good. Now, if you will excuse me.
Certainly.
Pop, I don't get it. We came all the way from New York City following a man named Roush.
Roush was murdered.
Who killed him?
Same person who left that heel print on floor. Right shoe. Print is duplicate of one found in cabinet scene of Roush murder. Killer someone who walked here recently. Perhaps someone we all see. Most interesting place. We'll visit here tomorrow.
Manager, please.
Who's calling?
This is Brett. Roush was contacted. He was scared. Said the police were after him. He was ready to blab because Charlie Chan was after him, too. But he can't talk now. He's dead. I borrowed Diana's car last night to go meet Roush. I want the address of the telephone number, Harding, 2535. Yes, I know, but this is Inspector Grady, Precinct Station 27. There you go. Where? Office 211. Algon Building? Thank you.
Next on this, please.
That's Gloria Bain, radio actress, small time, until she made a hit on Mrs. Marsh's program. Seems to be a gold digger, but she's a hard worker. No records. Diane Hall, radio actress from legitimate stage in New York, came here 2 months ago. Nothing definite on her, except that she lives with Gloria Bain.
Well, thank you so very much, Captain, for your excellent report on my list of suspects.
Charlie, you mean to tell me that you really think that one of these people here is a murderer?
Not only think so, but firmly believe so. But which one? We'll go now to try and find out which one is guilty person.
That's easy, Pop. The murderer will be the one with the guilty look.
Number three son have excellent head. Question have always been what it contained.
Well, if it ain't,
Ben Carter's my name.
Benjamin Carter, yeah. Boy, it's been a long time. I haven't seen you since...
Longer than that.
Yeah?
The last time I saw you, you was living...
Oh, I moved from there.
Yeah?
Sure, I moved over to,
How can you live in that neighborhood?
I don't know.
Now, where I'm living, I only pay...
It ain't that cheap, is it?
Sure it is.
Hey, look at you.
What?
Is you still married?
No, I divorced her.
Yeah? Sure. I know you have a lot of...
You got me wrong. You got me wrong. I got married again.
No kidding.
I sure did.
Yeah?
Say, not changing the subject, have you got a...
No, I don't smoke.
No.
Hey, look here. Wasn't you in the...
Yeah, but I got an honorable discharge.
You did?
I sure did.
What was the matter?
Well, I developed a kind of...
Oh, that's a terrible thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it starts right along...
No, more in the back.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing for it?
Well, I was taking some...
Don't take them, Ben. They'll make you sleep.
Yeah?
Sure. Now, what you should have taken...
I did.
You know what?
What?
That's how come I like to talk to you.
Yeah.
Because me and you seem to agree with each other.
We sure do, don't we?
Yeah. I wonder...
Oh, it's about...
Is it that late?
It sure is.
Well, thank you.
I'll be seeing you.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
A bonsoir.
Casa manana.
Come and tie the boot.
Friend.
He didn't say.
Huh?
No, he didn't say.
You know, Pop, I've got an idea about this case.
Yes, well?
Well, I had an idea, but it's gone now.
Possibly could not stand solitary confinement. Quiet, please. We go now to watch studio rehearsal.
No, Walter. You've broken your promise to me. Just when the landlord has broken our lease and Grandmama has broken her leg. Oh, Grandmama, what are we to do?
Well, tears are all right to wash out your eyes, but they used up too many handkerchiefs. So face the future with a smile, my children, for tomorrow is bound to be another day. It is just bound to be.
What does the future hold in store for Jean and her so lovable family? Have you tried a Marsh's mellow mixed waffle covered with just oodles and oodles of melted butter and...
Shut up! You too. Oodles and oodles of butter. With butter rations so strictly, who wrote that in?
Well, I thought it sounded nice.
You thought? That's a lie. The whole program sounds as stupid as you. I should cancel my contract here and give my account to some other network.
Mrs. Marsh, if that's how you feel about it, why don't you,
Why don't I... What, Mr. Brett?
Let us change the script and the announcement.
Then do it instead of talking about it. And you, learn how to talk like a human instead of a gloop, or I'll change announcers, too. Also, I...
Sorry to interrupt again.
Huh, you're sorry. If you want to speak to Miss Hall again, you'll wait till we're finished.
So sorry. Must speak to everyone present.
All of us?
But why?
Regarding a murder.
Murder? But yesterday you said you were investigating my stolen car.
Person who steal your car commit murder.
But who was killed?
A Mr. Rausch.
I never heard of him. Thank goodness.
You know what, Toby? I'd like to get on the radio sometime. If I could get on... Oh, excuse me. Tommy!
What's the matter?
I got a urge that I want to leave, but my legs won't cooperate with me.
You want to leave for where?
I just saw something going there. It's a combination between Dracula and a zombie. Just fresh out of a graveyard.
A graveyard?
Mm-hmm, but an old one.
Well, that I gotta see.
Well, go ahead. I ain't no hope.
What dost thou wish, laddie?
Oh, nothing, sir. Excuse me. A friend of mine was seeing things.
Did you see it?
Yeah, it's hanging right on the door.
It's hanging it in, not your left door.
Hi, Mama. We go 10th floor. Come.
Chan, it's good to see you again.
I'm most happy to see you, Mr. Hamilton. This is number three son, Tommy.
How are you?
And Birmingham Brown. These boys are second team assistants. You receive my telegram and follow instructions?
Immediately. All of our radar equipment has been taken away by the government.
What about record of experiments and copies of secret patents?
The government has the originals. I have my own copies in the safe.
Contents of safe only secure so long as someone outside watching safe.
You know, since receiving your wire, I've found evidence of several attempts to break in here. Do you think I ought to hire special guards?
No. Now that I am present, contents of safe becomes trap, and papers inside are only bait with which to catch enemy rat.
Sure, a lot of gadgets in here.
Yes, useful gadgets, too. Right here, we began the work that today allows our night fighters to hunt down and destroy enemy airplanes without even seeing them.
Gosh, that sounds spooky.
Nearly radar.
Radar? Radar? Well, what is radar?
Well, radar is, well, it's sort of, Birmingham, don't you know anything?
I know as much about radar as you do. Do I know anything? Now, you ought to know I studied radar.
What is that?
A temperature or a climatic tunnel.
You make weather in tunnel?
Yes. That is, the extremes of heat and cold. To test the reliability of radar and television in all sorts of climatic conditions. The tunnel has two compartments, one for heat and one for cold. That light works, flashing, whenever there's a foreign body in the tunnel, no matter what the weather in there.
Now, this is a funny thing, you know. What is this?
Mr. Chan! Help! Help! Mr. Chan! Help! Help!
Mr. Chan!
Birmingham, when in strange laboratories, do not poke nose into strange machines like these. Also, keep finger out of same. Goodbye, Mr.
Goodbye, Charlie. Thank you for coming in. Bye. Happy to have met you. Hope to see you some more.
Bye.
Goodbye, gentlemen. Come in.
May I speak to you for a moment, Mr. Brett?
Mr. Brett? Why all the formality, Gloria?
I'm here on business. I want better parts and more money. Starting tomorrow.
You'd say that as if you were ordering me to give them to you.
I am.
Now, look here, young lady. Instead of getting more parts, you're liable to lose those you already have.
I wouldn't be so hasty, Mr. Brett. You'd better let me finish.
Please, Gloria, I'm busy.
Remember these.
Remember them? What do you mean?
That's the last pack of my private matches, Mr. Brett. And I gave them to you yesterday morning in this building.
Well, does that entitle you to order me to give you better jobs?
Diane's car was stolen last night. I found these later in the seat. Well?
Is this blackmail?
Blackmail. Oh, that's bad, isn't it? Perhaps I'd just better give these to Mr. Chan and see what he says.
Oh, wait. I'll see that you get better jobs.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
The manager, please.
Who's calling?
This is Brett talking. Listen, Gloria Bain, an actress here, knows that I used Diana Hall's car last night. She's blackmailing me. What'll I do?
Personally, I think the program needs an entire change of personnel. However, I'll listen from my office, and then I'll decide.
What did you say?
Then don't say it. Come along.
Pop, how can we solve a case just by watching people through a glass?
What detective needs is great patience.
Oh, I know that. When it comes to detective work, I know my P's and Q's.
But are you familiar with the rest of alphabet?
Oh, Walter, to drink when your wife's in trouble, to say nothing of my broken leg.
Drink? It seems as though I've heard that word before.
What are we to do? Trouble? Nothing but trouble staring us in the face. We must move by the first of the month, and we've no place to go. Why can't we settle down and be like other people?
Now keep your chin up, Mary, and look on the brighter side.
Of course, Grandmama, you're always right. Always.
I never had such a sudden headache in my life.
I was all set to do some fancy ad-libbing myself. Uh-oh, the battle axe.
Well, it wasn't bad. That is, not as bad as usual. You sounded poorly toward the end. Better stop gadding about. Come along. You want to stand here talking all night?
Can I get you anything, Gloria?
A cigarette might help.
Oh. Thank you. Will you give me a light, Mr. Brett?
Why, of course.
Well, that's better.
Gloria, what happened?
That young lady to dressing room. Quick, hurry.
Bring her in here.
I beg your pardon.
Yes, please.
Why is it that whenever anything happens around here, you're always on hand?
That's just what they always telling me down at the office.
Hey, Tommy, I know the cigarette shortage is tough, but that ain't no reason why you should snitch a cigarette butt from that old lady.
You know I don't smoke, but what other people try to grab often turn out to be valuable clue.
Clue to what?
Well, that's what we'll have to find out.
You just including me out.
Did anybody call a doctor?
Doctor, no use now. Young lady already dead.
Dead?
The coroner was right, sir.
Well, he said Miss Bain was poisoned.
Toxic reaction proof she was. But I don't know what type poison was used. I've never run into it before.
Say, do you suspect any of the people who were present when she died?
Suspect everyone on general principle. But two assistants already watching person who interests me most. Thank you so much, Doctor.
Good night.
Good night.
What do you want?
Why, Cooper.
Broad. How are you? Not Broad now. It's Brett. Come on in.
It's Brett now instead of Broad, huh? It was Brett when we worked in France together, remember?
Seems like we're working together again.
Thought I recognized your voice on my phone. Asking for the manager, please.
Oh,
Oh, so you're the manager, the head man of the party, eh?
Not me. I just answer the phone. Someone else, someone unknown to me, listens in. If the caller is okay, the caller switched away from this line.
I see.
What do you care if we don't know who our boss is? We've worked that way before.
I've got to know, Cooper. There's been two murders on this job already.
Two murders? Yeah. I see what you mean. We should know the name of our boss to protect ourselves. Listen. Hello? Who's calling?
Manager, please.
See how it works?
Yeah, I see. Well, if you learn anything, let me know. We'll need a lot of information. We have to squeal.
What's the matter?
Someone's coming. I'm going.
You hear nothing which is said inside strange office?
Just a mumble and a jumble, Mr. Chan.
But outside in hall, you overhear Mr. Cooper call Mr. Brett Mr. Brought.
That's right, Pop.
Mean anything to you, Charlie?
British intelligence seeking espionage agent named Ralph Brought.
Ralph Brought? Oh, and the radio station manager calls himself Ralph Brett.
Nothing in office except table, chair, and telephone, huh?
Yes, sir. It must have been a race booker's office, because it was just as clean as I is when I make a bet.
Captain, please detail man to check all people coming and going from office 211 Algard Building.
Right.
Believe we make Mr. Brett surprise visit. Come.
Boy, here we go again. Surprise visit.
Don't surprise me.
Brett absent downstairs, also here.
Do you think he's run away, Pop? Is that the heel print you're looking for?
Person who wear this shoe, kill Roush.
My gosh, you mean Brett murdered this fellow Roush?
Must locate Mr. Brett at once. Manager, please.
Who's calling?
Brett. Listen, Charlie Chan knows all about the Roush murder. He's after me. You've got to protect me. What'll I do? Here in this building. And say Mr. Brett's still here, has not left building. Mr. Ryan.
Yeah.
You see Mr. Brett lately?
I saw him eavesdropping outside of his own office, as if there were a couple of ex-wives in there waiting to collect alimony. Not funny, huh?
When you see this?
About 20 minutes ago.
Pop, that's when we were in there.
Must ask police to guard all doors.
Police? Why?
Because Brett is a murderer.
Brett, a murderer? That kills me. Nice people I'm working for.
Birmingham, we've got to find Brett.
Well, what's the rush?
Because he's a killer.
Yeah, it'll just be my luck to catch up with him.
Come on.
Say, it's 8 hours since Brett has been seen. You know, he must have a hideout somewhere in this building.
You have men posted at every exit?
Sure, he can't get by them.
Think we'll take a look on various floors.
Good.
Gotta change the water before I'm cleaning some more.
You know, Birmingham, everywhere we go, we bump into that woman.
Oh, don't be so suspicious, Tommy. After a while, you'd be telling me I did the murder. Look here. Did you see...
Not in the last 10 minutes.
No.
No, but there was a fella here.
Him?
Yeah.
Oh, he ain't the one.
No.
No, the fella I'm looking for
is... I didn't see him. But if you wait until I...
I ain't got time.
No.
But maybe if you could...
I'm busy that night.
Oh, sure, no.
Yeah.
So look here.
What?
Do you think that,
No, it's getting late.
Yeah.
Why don't you
call... I ain't got a phone.
No.
But I could if you would...
Well, my car's in the shop.
Oh, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll see you then.
I'll be seeing you. Call me,
okay,
huh?
Kid.
Okay, so long.
All right, goodbye. Do you know that he...
He can't be that bad.
Look, the laboratory door's open.
Yeah?
Do you suppose Brett's in here?
Well, if he is, let him stay in there. I'm tired of tangling with them gadgets. Well, it ain't no use being this lonesome. Nobody home. Let's go.
Wait.
Oh, what's the matter?
Look, the safe been robbed. Perhaps the robber is still in here.
Robbers and murders. Why, this is a regular cleaning and dying place.
Let's get out of here. Come, come.
Could have been a little light around here. Uh-oh, I'm surrounded.
Come. Say, this looks like a good hiding place. Let's take a look.
Let's take a look. And nothing will do him to go in and take a look. You know what, Tommy? When you're hunting a killer, you're supposed to have a guard on the outside, just in case. So I think I'll stay on the outside, just in case.
In case of what?
That the killer's in here.
No, you stay with me.
All right.
Gosh, it's dark in here.
It sure is. Wait, I turn on the light.
Been robbed.
Looks in this case not deceiving. Flashing light indicates someone in tunnel. In tunnel?
Go away, Pop.
Was flicker light working when you come in here?
Heavy fall again.
Well, nothing matters, man.
I tell you, Bob, there's no one else in here. But the papers are missing from Hamilton State.
Someone besides assistants in this room.
Just finished, Charlie. He says Brett wasn't poisoned. He died of a fall from a great height.
Brett last seen alive on second floor of Cosmo building. Later, he found dead on 10th floor. Someone would have us believe victim fall 8 stories up.
Look at the telephone now.
No one sent for you.
Isn't the name Cooper?
Why, yes.
Go on with work. Mr. Cooper, alias Carper, alias Cowper.
Charlie Chan.
I remember you since last time I arrested you. 6 years ago in Singapore, remember?
Yeah, I remember.
Very great pleasure to arrest you again, Mr. Cooper. For whom you work now?
I'm not talking.
You talked with your friend, Mr. Brett, yesterday. Now he is murdered.
Brett? Murdered? I had nothing to do with it. I don't know who I work for. I only answer the phone. Someone else switches the calls. I never hear a thing.
You find out.
There's a cut-in relay installed here, Mr. Chan. Calls can be switched.
Can you locate place where calls switch to?
Yeah, but it might take a couple of days.
Keep working. You gentlemen will remain with Mr. Cooper. He will continue to answer phone calls as usual.
I'll do it. I'm not getting mixed up in murder.
Good. Mr. Dixon?
Yes, the radio impersonator.
Glad to meet you, Mr. Chan.
Radio impersonator, good. You know what you are to do? Death of Mr. Brett, not yet made public. Wish to try experiment.
I'm ready, sir.
Hello? Who's calling?
This is Brett calling. Hurry it up. Brett, I've got to see you.
He hung up.
Dead.
Use service elevator. Come, 7th floor. If I not there, come, 10th floor.
It's the unknown leader, Charlie.
The one you're after, the killer, Pop.
Thank you so much. Please say nothing of this to anyone.
I understand.
No one's in sight, Pop.
We go 10th floor. Wait. We go 10th floor by stairs. You go in elevator. That way we have killer between us.
Better than walking. Because I'm the pit. There's a long way down.
Help! Come here, somebody! Help!
Elevator already arrived. Birmingham, come out of there.
Is that you, Mr. Chan? For heaven's sakes, come get me out of here.
Well, get down yourself. Get down.
Oh, not without a parachute. One drop of this is certain death.
Birmingham, what are you talking about?
Mr. Chan, what is you standing on?
On the floor.
The floor? Oh,
get down.
Where did that floor come from?
Well, what do you mean, what floor come from? What?
Mr. Chan, when I was down on the seventh floor, that elevator floor went out from under me and left me standing on nothing.
You can sure imagine things, Birmingham.
Imagine? No, I ain't, Mr. Chan. When I went in that elevator, the elevator door closed. That floor went out from under me just like a trap door and left me hanging on my fingernail. I was looking out 8 or 9 floors, straight down.
You mean to say bottom of elevator fall out?
Yes, sir.
Perhaps Mr. Brett received same message we get.
You mean come to the 7th floor, then to the 10th, Pop?
Believe fate save us from dying same way Mr. Brett died. He was killed by fall from great height. We descend to basement.
Yes, Pop.
No, not by elevator. Come. Bloodstains on floor of shaft. This is where Mr. Brett fall to death.
You're getting to be a habit, coming in here and interrupting my program rehearsals. It's an outrage.
Murder also outrage.
Do you know what I pay for my programs?
I'm interested only that murderer shall pay for killing of Miss Bain and Mr. Brett. You all present when Miss Bain die.
You're stupid thinking these people would murder anyone. They're too busy murdering the English language.
Testimony is Miss Bain say she expect more work and more money.
Gloria did say something like that.
That's right.
Who can give her more work and more money? Mr. Brett?
Certainly. He's the slave driver. Or rather, he was.
Very friendly with Mr. Brett?
Gloria couldn't stand him.
She detested him and... Oh.
Yes?
I just remembered. Gloria did say she'd talked with Brett. Gloria said he'd promised her a lot more work. I was surprised because I knew he liked her no better than she liked him.
Wait, Gloria did say something like that. Something about... Oh.
Yes, she say what, Mr. Wren?
Oh, I don't recall. You see, I gab a lot and other people gab back at me. I can't remember half of the things I hear.
Please try to remember. Might be most important clue.
Yes, yeah, surely. It'll come back to me. And when it does, I'll tell you right away, sir. Mm,
thank you. That is all. Thank you so much.
Thanks indeed. Come, Herbert.
Well, what do you make of it, Charlie?
So many fish in fish market. Even flour smells same. Much confusion.
We go on in 20 seconds.
This is Television Experimental Station, WXK9X, presenting Willie Rand, ace comedian, in his own conception of the dance of the spirit.
What you do here?
Pop, we were just about to go out to look for you.
So it seems.
Honest, Pop. Mr. Rand said he remembers something important. He wants to see you right after this show.
Fever and didn't ask for
it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we transfer you to Telestudio number 2, where Miguel Moreno and his marimba band carry on during the second portion of the program.
Well, Willie, what happened to your closing speech?
Did you forget it?
Yes, Willie, what happened?
I don't know what happened.
You got a cigarette? Thanks, old.
Mr. Rand, number three son, Tommy, tell me you remember something you wish to tell me.
Now I remember what Gloria told me. And I've got a lot of other good information for you, too.
Yes, yes.
This afternoon, when I was up on the seventh floor, I saw...
Why, what trouble, Mr. Rand?
Charlie, he's dead.
Dead? Get cigarette, he smoked. Have same analyzed quickly. Mr. Chester, you come with me.
Mr. Chan, my office is never locked. The people on television and radio are in and out of here at all hours. Mr. Chan, I've never seen that thing before in my life.
One moment, please. This is obviously control switch for mysterious trap door in service elevator. Mr. Chester, we visit police headquarters.
Rand was poisoned by the same stuff that killed Miss Bain. But there is no poison in the cigarette he smoked.
They said Miss Bain smoked a cigarette just before she died, Pop.
Yes. Also given her by Mr. Chester.
That janitress. She picked this up right where Miss Bain fell. I took it away from her.
This is cigarette smoked by Miss Bain?
Yes.
Test it. Why you not mention this before?
Guess it slipped my mind, Pop.
Oh, slipped mine.
There's no poison in this either.
Release, Mr. Chester.
Oh, but Charlie, the gadget that worked the elevators in his office.
Sure, he must be the unknown espionage leader we're after, Pop.
Person who send messages to Mr. Brett on teletype machine must have similar machine at other end of line. There is no teletype instrument in Mr. Chester's office. Release him.
What are we to do? Trouble? Nothing but trouble staring at us.
This program is strictly slush.
It is transcription of last program made by Miss Bain when she dies so strangely. Only wish to hear end of program.
We must move by the first of the month, and we've no place to go. Why can't we...
Hey, she must have stepped nearer the microphone.
She did. Please, turn up volume. Now listen very quietly.
Down? And be like...
You hear strange noise?
Yes, a popping noise when she was sobbing.
We hear same noise on record of Mr. Rand's voice made during television broadcast. Believe now know how both Miss Bain and Mr. Rand were killed. We'll need assistance of radio technician to prove it. Please?
Right away. Those look like bits of glass.
Or gelatin used in making capsule. We have only part of proof. Now we visit Studio C downstairs. Murderer ready to do more business. This is what we look for. Thank you so much.
Doc, my radio man said that the studio microphones were rigged so that a short wave radio beam sent from some part of the building, it would explode those capsules.
There is some sort of colorless gas in the capsule, Mr. Chan, but it certainly is not poison.
Cigarette, please, Doctor.
When did you start smoking, Pop?
Quiet. Would you kindly light same, please? Now, you will blow some smoke into the beaker.
Just what do What is it, Pop?
Well, that's it, Mr. Chan. Alone, either the gas or the cigarette is harmless.
But if someone first inhaled gas and then pretty soon smoked cigarette...
The combination of gas and nicotine becomes a poison and kills instantly.
Thank you so much, Doctor. That is exactly what I wanted to know.
Yeah. My men are at every exit with orders not to let any of our people leave the building.
Good. Mrs. Marsh, Mr. Sinclair, and Miss Hall already here. Well?
Chester, Nelson, and Carlos are in the building, Pop. Even that wacky janitress.
Good. All suspects on hand. Come. Believe leader of enemy agents and killer of Roush have office somewhere on this floor. Office containing teletype machine.
Okay. We'll soon find out.
Birmingham, you take another office.
Alone, not me. I like company.
Look. Pop, Captain Flynn, we found one.
You suppose this is the machine we want?
Could be. Here is shortwave radio set used to explode death capsule. Guards at exits. Right. I go other end of tunnel. We catch murderer between us.
Yes, Pop. We'll catch the guy while Pop's waiting for him. Come with me.
Sure. Whoa. I think I'll stick with Mr. Chan.
Now listen, Birmingham. When we see him, I'll hit him high, you hit him low. Understand, Birmingham? Birmingham! Birmingham!
I wonder what happened to that.
Okay, son?
Sure, Pop. The guy couldn't hit the side of a body even if he was inside of it.
Come, hurry.
The elevator is at the first floor, Pop. He must have gone down.
He tried to come down the stairs as I went up. I fired, and he came back this way.
Again, we just escaped death by elevator.
Pop, there's someone in office 703. The door's open.
Go, quick.
Come on, let's get out.
Murderer now travel without costume disguise. Come.
Pop,
killer caught in own trap. We find murderer in basement. Come.
Then you're not a Swedish janitress at all.
This is Miss Janet Carter, government investigator.
I came here a month ago at Mr. Chan's orders.
To keep eye on people coming and going from radar laboratory.
No one suspected the janitress of being a government operative.
You were a very great assistance, Janet. No, please, do not look at her.
Her?
Mrs. Marsh.
No, I'd never have believed it.
Hey, Pop, what about the stolen radar papers?
Papers she stole are worthless. Real radar secrets removed some time ago at my suggestion.
What's the matter? What's wrong, Charlie?
As usual, at end of case, I have discovered everything except whereabouts of my second assistant, Birmingham Brown.
Yeah, where did he go?
Hey, which way is out? I want to get away from these faces. They're scaring people. Oh, right out this way. Woo! Good grief. Ha! Ha! Come here, sir. Oh, that's me. But let me see this thing. I think I'd rather take this one. Goodbye.